Hey guys, Ivan here, and we have a lot of physique updates at about 9 days out of Iron Classic, but before we get to that, we have a lot of them, but before, I wanna show you what is in the thumbnail and what is in the title of the video, and probably the reason why majority of you came to watch this video. You wanna see some drama here, you want some drama, admit it, but don't be embarrassed about it. Everybody likes drama, I mean, that's natural, that's human nature. And I got some drama for you guys for this video, so stay tuned, I'm gonna show you what's going on between Patrick Moore and Sergio Oliva. So, let's cut to the chase, let me show you.
Patrick got top 10, if you add the four people that were missing, yeah. They got the same place that I did at the Olympia, which is last. You're 15th, you're last. It's the same place. My God, can we please stop talking about how someone placed something at an Olympia where nobody was there? So all these people going in that are starting to kind of believe their own hype, I think it's actually going to shoot themselves in the foot, because there is no way in hell any of the people that placed top 10 at the Olympia, you know, not the first call, obviously, are going to beat me. There's no way. To being beat by someone who got 9th or 10th is just, it's just bullshit. It's not gonna happen. As much as everybody wants it to happen, it's not going to. Yeah. I wasn't as fortunate as Patrick to come out and stand next to Juan and Akim. Right. My first Olympia, I came out and stood between Phil Heath and Big Ramos.
That's true.
All right, that was it. That was Sergio Oliva firing shots at Patrick Moore. So basically what he said is, to summarize all this, that Patrick got 10th place, he got in the top 10 at the Mr. Olympia, but certain people weren't there, they were missing. He says 4 people, but really it was 3. It was Phil, Sean and Big Ramy. He was probably counting Kai Green, but Kai has been retired for a long time. His last Mr. Olympia was 2014, so should we count Dennis Wolf as well? His last one was 2013. No, so it was 3 people who were missing, but anyways, that's besides the point. Right now, we're gonna discuss this a little bit later, and right now I'm gonna show you what Patrick had to say to Sergio Oliva to defend himself. Check this out.
So I'm headed to work this morning, and on my way, I get sent an interview where a particular athlete seemed to be concerned with the Olympia last year and the placings and the people that were there, and making predictions on the show. It's not all talk me on that stage, man. So keep in mind, you know, I'm 5 years in, going on 6. Ton of guys been here way, way longer. So all the would've, could've, what should've been, if who was there, what would've, blah, blah, blah. Man, just bring him on the stage. That's all that matters. All the sideways talk, talking about where you're gonna place, who can't stand next to who, based on whatever, shape, all that nonsense, who can't do this. Just make sure you bring it on show day, man.
Ho ho ho, Patrick is firing back. So what Patrick had to say is that Sergio Oliva is all about coulda, woulda, shoulda. And that's a valid point, that's a valid point. If Sergio could have done better at the Mr. Olympia 2019, he should have came. But we're gonna see what's gonna happen at the Arnold Classic 2020 in about 9 days. But if you are too anxious to wait for those 9 days, come back to my channel in about a couple of hours. I'm gonna post another video, yeah, 2 videos today, and this second video is gonna be about comparing Patrick Moore to Sergio Oliva, comparing their physiques. And I know these guys are very close, right? They are about the same age, similar weight, they have achieved similar things, and they're gonna be colliding against one another, and they're both bringing very good physiques, and they're improved, and they are about the same size, same caliber. At this point, I'm not sure who's gonna do better or who's gonna take what place, but I'm gonna talk furthermore into detail in the next video that I'm gonna post, so come back here in about a couple of hours, you're gonna see a new video. But as for now, shots fired, Patrick and Sergio Oliva are becoming 2 rivals, and I love that, I love that. This is what we need in bodybuilding. I mean, it's boring without some drama. I mean, let's not say we are drama queens or whatever. We want to see something happening, right? It happens in all sports, and it's a normal part of any sport, really. It's just a rivalry. We want to see more rivalry. You can put it that way. You can say it's rivalry, or you can say it's drama. Whatever you want to say, it's the same thing, and you know, we all like it. Let's go with the next story now. 9 days out of Arnold, and this is Nathan D'Asha. What do you think? Well, me personally, I don't see it. I don't see him doing well. I mean, he will probably be, you know, in the first call out. I mean, possibly, maybe out of first call out, second or first, but can he be in that top 4? I don't think so. No. He's not conditioned enough. He's very full, but not conditioned. He started this prep a little bit too late. He should push the envelope as much as he can right now, but it's only 9 days left, and he doesn't look very lean. And he also posted this video, this training video, and you can see his stomach. It's huge. It's a huge bubble gut. I don't know if this is gonna look like this on stage. He will probably manage to hide it somehow, but look at this. This is just horrible. This is just horrible to see. I mean, he shouldn't have posted this kind of training videos. Doesn't look good. Doesn't look good at all. We also have a physique update of Akim Williams, and this guy is going to be probably one of the biggest guys on that stage. Look at him, look at those shoulders. He's actually bringing some decent conditioning, and he tends to come really lean, but his thick skin somehow manages to hide the muscle. So I know he diets very hard. You can see his glutes are always shredded, but especially back doesn't get very detailed. They say it's this thick skin, but I'm not sure what that means, really. But, you know, if he comes detailed, you know, peeled, shredded to the bone, once, this guy can do some serious damage, right? I mean, what's he missing? Who can challenge him in the size department on this Arnold Classic? Very few people, let me tell you. He has a big head, and it makes his physique look a little bit smaller when he's standing alone, but when he stands next to the other guys, he just looks absolutely enormous. And yeah, he was able to beat Patrick at the Mr. Olympia, and the only reason for that was the size. And also the fact that Patrick was a little bit overlooked, he wasn't really a big name at that point, now his name definitely grew. And look at the captions of his photos, look at what he says. He wants to be the best in the world, no matter what. He's ready to go through hell and high water. Basically, he's really, really determined. And I love to see this kind of mindset. He wants to be the Mr. Olympia. He doesn't want to be top 6 at the Arnold, like Sergio Oliva is planning this year. I mean, maybe he's dreaming too big. Maybe he is not having realistic expectations. But that's the mindset of a champion, really. He wants to be the best in the world. And there is a slight chance that he actually might become one day. If he doesn't believe it from the early start, it's probably not gonna happen. But then again, you have Ronnie Coleman, who never really thought it may happen, and you had Jay Cutler, who always knew he's going to become the best one. So it really doesn't matter in the end, apparently, based on the experience of these two guys. But here you can see that Patrick is really determined. Does this mean that he can win the Arnold Classic? Absolutely not, in my opinion. I don't think he's that caliber yet. But this means that he's gonna make a jump. And I think this year, he's going to be able to beat Akim Williams. I don't really expect Akim to come, peeled, as he never was. It's not realistic. I think Patrick is going to be improved just a little, and that little is going to be enough to beat guys like him. Going back to Sergio Oliva, so he posted this photo on his story. Is this recent or not? I'm positive this is from this prep. Is it at about 9 days out, like today or yesterday? I don't think so. I think he got leaner. But you can see the size. He was never this big. Ever before. He never had this pop, this 3D look. He looks really, really good this time around, and I'm positive this is gonna be the best Sergio Oliva ever. It's gonna be good enough to crack the top 4 that he wants, actually, or top 6, I wouldn't really say so. He doesn't have like the best structure possible, high lats, a little bit wider waist, arms not as big as the legs, and so on. You're gonna watch the next video comparing him next to Patrick, you're gonna see his weaknesses, but the best Sergio Oliva ever, absolutely, absolutely, he's bringing it. Let's talk a little bit more about the third call out at the Arnold Classic this year, and you're gonna see Victor Martinez in it. The old timer, for his age, he looks great. I mean, he's an old man who is really in a good shape, but, you know, can he really beat some of these younger guys? Maybe a couple of them, maybe, like Morgan East, I believe he can beat him. He can probably beat Johnny Jackson, I'm not sure how much older he is, but yeah, for an uncrowned Mr. Olympia, for, you know, almost the best bodybuilder in the world, 2007, he doesn't look, you know, at his prime, of course, but just the fact that he's still competing and looking like this, it's really amazing. You gotta give him that. Will he do great? No, but he's gonna be there with the young guys. He's gonna be there in 2020 at the Arnold Classic, which is an amazing fact by itself. Maybe he's gonna do great, but honestly, the conditioning doesn't look that good. And anything else, like, he is big, but the conditioning, again, like last year, not great at this point. What about this youngin? Compared to the Victor Martinez, he's definitely very, very young. And unfortunately, he's not doing the Ohio. I don't know why. I don't know why. The organizers should have invited him as well, for sure. I mean, look at him. He would definitely do great. He has like 1,200,000 followers on IG, so he's definitely a big name at this point. Yeah, he just turned pro and he's doing his pro debut. I'm sure next year they're gonna invite him, but whatever he does, I'm sure he's gonna do great. He's doing the Arnold Classic South America. Yeah, I'm sure. No, Arnold Classic Australia or both. I'm not sure. You guys let me know. I'm sure he's doing Australia. I'm not sure about the South America, but I'm pretty sure he's doing that one as well. And he's gonna do amazing, I'm sure. Look at him. He's huge and he's shredded. And this is a new physique update of Blessing Awodibu. In the meantime, at Flex Lewis's gym, the Dragon Slayer, Rafel Brandao is prepping for his show, also Arnold Classic South America. Can he be beaten by Blessing Awodibu? It's quite possible, actually, I might say. But probably not gonna happen. This guy is already established. Last year he was second. He was beaten by Juan Morel, and the only reason for that was the upper body. I mean, the legs were definitely not the reason, because Juan had no legs. This guy has outstanding legs, and he definitely grew some muscle this offseason. A lot of muscle, actually. So it's gonna be amazing seeing him back on stage. He really represents the aesthetics in bodybuilding. I love this guy. I love this guy. People want him to go to Classic, but he doesn't need to go to Classic. He's really big. He just looks very classic. He wouldn't do great in a classic physique. This guy is an absolute bodybuilder. He is big. Look at him compared to Flex. Flex doesn't look as big as him right now, but first of all, Flex took some time off. Second of all, this guy's probably pumped and, you know, under great lighting, and he has the angle, and he is, you know, without any clothes in a pose. So obviously that's why he looks bigger. He has no more muscle than Flex, pound for pound, that's for sure. But I'm definitely very excited to see Rafael Brandao once again on the stage, new and improved. And for the end of this physique update section, at about 9 days out of Arnold Classic, we have Josh Lenartowicz with his physique update. And honestly, I'm not impressed. I'm not impressed. His stocks fell down, at least in my eyes. I gave him a little bit too high place in my prediction video. If you haven't watched it, go ahead and watch it and tell me, do you think, was I right? Because he doesn't look very full, he doesn't look as big as he was last year, and I mean, sure, he's conditioned, but there is no pop, he looks very flat. He says that he's suffering migraines every single day, and that he's in chronic pain, he can't sleep, he's in a lot of trouble, he doesn't feel good, and you can see it in his physique. He doesn't look very healthy, he doesn't look very good. Not healthy at all. Look at his face. I mean, he looks very sick. He looks something like Dallas McCarroll looked a week before he died. I mean, God forbid he's not gonna die. He had the surgery, and that's why this all happened. It's just side effects of the surgery. He's gonna be healthy after he recovers, but the recovery process is long and painful, and he was probably calculating and thinking, if I'm gonna suffer, let me suffer for a reason. And when you're prepping, you can't enjoy anything. So if he's taking some time off, he should enjoy his life. And when he needs to suffer, he better suffer for something else, you know, for a cause. And that's going to be this Arnold Classic. But again, to respond to Nick Strength and Power, can he win an Arnold Classic? Any one of three of them? No, no, not with this shape. I don't see that happening at this point. Based on this physique update, I cannot see him winning any Arnold Classic. Probably not even placed in top six. But we'll see, we'll see. Maybe this downsized version of him, a little bit downsized, with better conditioning, actually does better. You know, it's possible. But he just doesn't look very fresh and very full and popping and stuff like that, like the other guys. So whatever you guys think about the whole thing between Sergio Oliva and Patrick Moore, who is right, whatever you think, tell me down below. What do you think about Josh's physique or whatever physique you saw in this video? Like the video if you enjoyed it, first of all, and subscribe if you want to see more physique updates and all kinds of bodybuilding videos, especially now following Arnold Classic. I promise you, I'm gonna bury you with content. Nobody else is gonna have more Arnold Classic videos. I'm gonna update you every single minute. I'm gonna work as hard as I can. So guys, subscribe, like the video, all the best, and bye-bye.